In this video, we're going to see what are associations and what are references. We're going to see the differences between the two. We're going to have an example of when to use associations and when to use references. Before we jump into Codebeamer, just a few things to mention. So associations are ad hoc relations between tracker items and any of the other Codebeamer entities. In contrast to references, associations do not have defined value set, severity or permissions, and all users who have access to a tracker item can create new item associations, regardless of the item status. We highly recommend using references above associations because associations are lightweight connections. When you're trying to create an association, you have a fixed list of values, which we're going to see in a bit, while when you're using references, you can get much more creative because you're using fields for those references. Now let's jump into Codebeamer and see how it looks like. When it comes to creating associations, we can pick any of the work items. So let's pick the first of the requirement that we have. Let me open up in the detail view. Here in the associations tab, we have the option to add association. Let's click that. Once that's open, we can select the type of the association. As I mentioned, this is a fixed list. So these are only the values that can be used for this lightweight connection. Now let's see an example of how we are using the associations in Codebeamer. We have a traceability report prepared. We're going to see the bugs, the software test cases, and the software requirements. If we take a look at the result of the report, we can see that this bug is associated to this test case. There are two main scenarios where we are using associations, or when we are suggesting to use associations. One is when a bug is associated to a test case, and the second one when we copy an item from the library. So first, let's take a look at the bug. If I open up the bug in the detail view, we're going to see that down here in the downstream references tab, there's going to be no downstream references whatsoever regarding the test cases. That's because in this scenario, we are using associations so that the bug is associated to a test case from which it was created. The other example would be copying from the library. For that, let's go to a tracker. Let's choose the software requirements. On the right side, select the library. Currently, we are in the integrations project, but we're going to copy another item from the Codebeamer automotive template. So let's find a software requirement, drag it, and drop it over to our current project. We're going to make a copy of this item. We're going to ignore the warning now, because that field is not relevant for our scenario. I'm going to click on save, and the item is going to be created. If I go back to the properties of that item, scroll down to the associations, we can immediately see that this item that is in our current project is associated to the original item, which was copied over from the other project. It's also written here that this item that we're currently viewing is a copy of the item that is associated. So now, as I mentioned, we are in the integrations project. Let me click on this association, and we're going to be navigated to the other project, which is the original item that we copied over from this project. Now let's take a look at references. Generally, we recommend to use references over associations because references can be used to trigger actions by workflows, and guard conditions can be built with them. Also, lifecycle traceability is enforced with references because those are stored in fields. You're going to see that in a bit. In this report, we have some software requirements that has downstream reference to a software user story, and that user story also has a downstream reference to a task. So let's see how this looks like in the configuration. I'm going to open up the task. We're going to see the details of this task. As I mentioned, the references are stored in fields. So we can immediately see that there is a field called upstream reference where our current user story is already assigned. If I click on that, we're going to be navigated to our user story. And we can also see that on the user story, there is also a field, this time it's called software requirement, that is pointing to our software requirement. If I click on that, we're going to be navigated to the software requirement. The other way around, since we are on the top level now, If I check the downstream references tab, we're going to see that we have two downstream references. This time we're going to focus on the user story. If I click on that, we're going to be navigated back to the user story, where we also have a downstream reference to the task from where we started. So this is how it looks like in Codebeamer, and this is how you create fields to create traceability.